In this video, I'll discuss one of the core HTML editor features, mentions. So, what are mentions, and how can you leverage this new feature in your next Angular, jQuery, React, or Vue web application? Mentions represents a special autocomplete mechanism that is triggered when users enter a specific prefix, such as @ or hashtag. Our implementation supports multiple single character prefixes or markers. Each marker can be associated with its own data source, be it local or remote. These markers are quite flexible. For instance, you can specify the minimum number of characters required before popup content is filtered, and of course, the data fields that will be searched and displayed. You can also specify a custom template for your drop-down list items, or simply use our elegant default template. Finally, you are free to change the appearance of a mention within a document by setting the appropriate template. With that brief overview, let's get started and let's take a look at our HTML editor's mentions demo app. I'll be using the Angular version of the demo, but remember that the DevExtreme HTML editor fully supports Angular, React, Vue, ASP.NET Core, and MVC. Okay, I'm going to enter the @ marker to activate the dropdown list. Ironically enough, notice that the dropdown list does not actually drop down at this particular screen resolution. The reason, of course, is because had the dropdown appeared below the edit field, its values would be obscured. Dropdown list position is managed automatically by our HTML editor. In this demo, we're using our default template to render the dropdown list. As you can see, the list includes employee names along with an icon. You are free to customize the contents of the list based on your data source item list. Let me go ahead and enter O and L to demonstrate the autocomplete feature. As you can see, the list is automatically filtered, and Olivia Payton's record is now the only value displayed within the list. Oh, and also notice that since space exists, the dropdown appears below my edit position. Okay, let me select Olivia's record. Note that once selected, the mention looks just like the mentions in collaboration tools like Microsoft Teams. The configurations options used in this demo are as follows. We use the nested DXI mention component among others and configure the following options. Display EXPR to specify the data field whose value will be displayed, and search EXPR to enable filtering by the text field. The formatting for these mentions created is set in the template option. Our HTML editor enables you to use different resource types for mentions. You've just seen the first type, people. Now I will show you how to mention issues. Go back to the mention and enter a hashtag. Then choose an item from a drop-down list. Note that the list looks different due to the template customization. Let's review the following code. Here is the issue's template code. This mentions type is also configured in the nested DXI mention component. We specified a distinct marker for this mention type and two values for the search EXPR property so that we can filter by two different fields. The drop-down list item's appearance is configured via the item template option. And that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this overview on mentions support within our JavaScript HTML editor. If you liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring the bell for more great DevExpress videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.